Hello, anatomists. Michele Glass, ear. I'm so sorry. I can't help myself. Today, we are going to be talking about, you guessed it, the ear. I have some structures to show you on models, and then I'll do another video with the diagrams. So, to begin, we are talking about what we call the external ear. So the external ear here, this portion is called the pinna or auricle. So of course the job of the pinna or the auricle is to funnel sound waves into what is called our external auditory canal, or you can be fancy and say external acoustic meatus. Now, you've learned that structure before. If you remember our old friend, the skull, your favorite part of AMP1, I am sure. We have our passageway here on the temporal bone called the external auditory canal or the external acoustic meatus. So, you've studied that structure before. Now, I have two different ear models, and I'm going to try to go back and forth between. So, looking at this giant one, here's the pinna or auricle, and then this passageway here, of course, external auditory canal. Now, lining that passageway, you have special glands called ceruminous glands, and that's going to be where cerumen or earwax is manufactured. Okay, so the external ear ends right here at the tympanic membrane. So tympanic membrane, let me pull it out from this other model, is what you've called probably your whole life the eardrum. Okay, so external ear goes from the pinna, external auditory canal, to the eardrum. Then we get into what would be called the middle ear. Now the middle ear is housed in another structure that we learned from AMP1, which is the petrous part. So here's the front of the skull. I'm rotating it and looking inside. You have the petrous part of the temporal bone. So both the middle and the inner ear would be housed inside that structure. So it's super, super tiny, much, much smaller than what we're seeing with our model. Okay, so when we go from the tympanic membrane, we're in the middle ear right here, and this space right behind is called the tympanic cavity. And what we're going to see attaching to the temporal membrane are three little bones called auditory ossicles. And so, ossicles, just like tiny bone. And on this model, I can show you too. We have the malleus and then the incus. And then it's broken, but this is where the stapes, which is the third bone, would attach. And this little plastemount here, we can see malleus, which is going to be on the tympanic membrane, incus, which connects the malleus to the stapes. Okay, so let me pull it out from this other model. So here's another view. Here's the malleus. You can see it hitting on the tympanic membrane. Here's the incus. And then the incus knocks up against the stapes. Okay, and it breaks, apparently. It's broken on these models. Now you have two important muscles that are helping to stabilize these bones. So what's happening is the sound waves go into the external auditory canal and then knock, 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 knock against that tympanic membrane. So just like a drum, it's vibrating, it's moving. That vibration, that movement gets transferred to the malleus, the incus, and the stapes. And then the stapes transfers that to the inner ear. So we have some muscles that help stabilize those bones so that we don't have like these big dramatic bumps, because that can damage, that can cause permanent hearing loss, right? Okay, so we're going to be looking at the tensor tympani muscle. So let me see if I can show you that on my big model here. Okay, I hope I didn't just hurt your ears. So that was probably pretty loud. This is the tensor tympani muscle. So it's actually going to be going to the malleus and helping to stabilize the malleus. So the malleus, remember, hits on the tympanic membrane. So tensor tympani is again talking about like that tympanic membrane. Okay, so it's this big one here. I can show you that on this model, perhaps. Let's see. You can see it here. So the second muscle that we're looking at today is called the stapedius muscle, and so this is going to attach to the stapes. The stapes is going to be, remember, transferring the sound wave to the inner ear. And so stapedius is talking about this muscle that's going to be articulating onto the stapes, and the stapes here is broken off. So remember, it's going to be kind of like a little V shape right there. So that would be the stapedius. And that's probably the best place I have to show you that on the model. Okay. So we've done the external ear. We just finished the middle ear with the exception of one structure. So I did just remember. We also have, coming from that tympanic cavity, this is our auditory tube. Auditory tube, which we can also call the pharyngotympanic or the Eustachian tube. Okay, so that's going to the pharynx, which is at the back of the throat. All right, so now we finished the middle ear. So what we have next to look at is the inner ear. Now, the inner ear is going to be where three different sensations are actually detected. So we think of our ear as being involved in the sensation of hearing. And so that's the structures that we've been talking about so far. But we'll also see that the inner ear detects what's called linear acceleration. So forward and backward movement, the pull of gravity, okay? And then also like rotation. So the inner ear helps us to kind of orient where our head is in space. On planet Earth, meaning with the pull of gravity. Okay, so as we look at the inner ear, we're going to see that there are structures for detection of the sensation of hearing, for linear acceleration and gravity, and then also rotation. Okay, so looking at this model here, we can see our inner ear. And remember, this is going to be housed in that petrous part of the temporal bone. So let me just pull this out. Now remember, we have three sensations we're detecting. So we have the cochlea, which is where we're going to detect hearing. We have the vestibule, which is where we're going to detect that linear acceleration and gravity. And then we have what are called the semicircular canals. And this is where we're going to get that rotation. Position of our head, kind of in space there. Okay. Now, looking at the cochlea, this is actually the structure that the stapes is going to hit on. So, remember when you're hearing my voice, the sound wave is traveling into the external auditory canal. It's bumping up against the tympanic membrane. That vibration is transferred to the malleus, to incus. Excuse me, malleus, incus, and stapes. And then the stapes knocks up against the cochlea at a structure called the oval window. So on this model here, I can see the oval window. I'm going to go ahead and take off. Wait, there. That's good. There's the oval window. And then close that hand, you have the round window. So the stapes knocks. This is the broken stapes. It's knocking against the oval window, transferring those sound waves into fluid waves. And then there's a release of that wave at the round window. So just like a tide that goes in and out, as the sound wave is transferred into a fluid wave, it goes in at the oval window and it has to go out at the round window. Okay? Okay. So we've also looked here at the vestibule. The vestibule contains structures that are part of the membranous labyrinth. Those structures, we have what's called the utricle, and then the saccule below. So the utricle and the saccule, I'll give more information on those in the diagram video, and they're going to be part of that linear acceleration and gravity sensation, and they're housed inside that vestibule space. So we can see that kind of here. The other part of the inner ear is the semicircular canals. And this model is nice because it shows you these models are old and falling apart, and the liquid inside there is not moving as well as it should. But you can see that these chambers, these semicircular canals, are going to be full of fluid. Let me orient it back into the model. And we can then see an anterior semicircular canal, a posterior semicircular canal, and then a lateral semicircular canal. So we have anterior, posterior, and lateral semicircular canal. So that's given us the orientation in, you know, different directions. And remember, you're getting that information from both your left and your right side. Now, when we look at the base of each one of those semicircular canals, we will have a structure called ampulla. So the ampulla would be located here. So here on this model, we're missing a semicircular canal is broken off, but we can still see the location of where the ampulla would be. I'll be giving more information on the ampulla in the diagram video, okay? Now, as we look at the inner ear, as we look at the cochlea, which is like the snail shell, and the vestibule, and the semicircular canals with one that's broken, we see that this structure is encased in bone. So some of the bone is broken off here, some of the bone is broken off there. We call this bone encasing the inner ear the bony labyrinth. The bony labyrinth. So we call the bone encasing the inner ear the bony labyrinth. Inside, full of this fluid, we're going to have the membranous labyrinth. Now there's going to be two different fluids in the ear. This fluid that's pictured here would be endolymph. Endolymph is inside the membranous labyrinth. There is a fluid that's going to be in between the bone and the membrane, and the fluid surrounding on the outside of the membranous labyrinth would be called the perilymph. Okay, so when we talk about the bony labyrinth, we see inside that you have a membranous labyrinth. So we're going to talk about the membranous labyrinth inside the cochlea as being the cochlear duct. And then we're going to talk about the membranous labyrinth inside the semicircular canals as being the semicircular ducts. So we'll see that terminology as well. The last piece for us to label on the model would be the vestibulocochlear cranial nerve, or you may have called this auditory nerve. And so either name for this is fine. Remember, this is our cranial nerve, number 8, and you can see it here as well. Now we should have a better understanding of the term vestibulo, meaning coming from the vestibule, and cochlear, meaning coming from the cochlea. So of course, I've got that snail shape off here, okay? Or of course, auditory, as it refers to our sense of hearing. All right, so don't forget to watch the video from the diagrams, and then there'll be a set of practice videos for you as well. Send me your questions. Take care of yourself and each other.